Hello, in this video we're taking a look at purchasing a Nord Stage 3 sound pack, or also known as a Nord Stage 3 library file or additional sounds, or if you're in a cover band and you want some cover songs. This is actually a purchasable sound pack, something you can buy off the internet, download and install on your Nord Stage 3. They're pre-programmed by other people and made for sale for you to enjoy or to use, especially if you're in a cover band, you're trying to duplicate these songs or the sounds from the songs. It takes a long time to do that from scratch at times, and you may not have the time to do all that, so it might be nice to just to buy a pack or two and get you started, especially if they are representing songs you actually want to play, either in your band or on your own. And if you're not in a cover band, then these are just fun to have and explore, especially if you're trying to learn songs from the great artists. So let's take a look at buying some of these sound files. And if you're brand new here, my name is Mark, and this is a channel called My Keys to Music. And right now we're focused on helping people with their Nord Stage 3, their Nord Electro 5, their Nord Electro 6. I do training, I do exploratory surgery in terms of understanding the keyboards. I also do discovery videos where we appreciate songs and things like that. So if you're interested in all that and you find yourself wanting to own a Nord keyboard, or you already do, feel free to subscribe. I also have a professional course at mykeystomusic.com. So let's take a look. I've got a couple of bookmarks here, and here I have a link to Synthcloud. This is a site made available here for people who own a Nord. In fact, they represent all kinds of keyboards. There's Korg and Roland and all, you know, the big manufacturers. These sounds are made for those keyboards that can take third-party influence from programmers and things like that and download the packs so you can enjoy on your own. Now, this one was actually brought to my attention from a current student at My Keys to Music. Basically, he raised his hand and sent me an email and said, "Mark, can you show me how to install these? Because it's not as straightforward, perhaps, as it is from installing sounds from the Nord website, for example." So I said, "Yeah, I'll make a video for that." So let's do this. So this one's called Nord, the famous Synth XL. It's specifically for the Nord Stage 3. And let's take a look at what we're going to get with this. We're going to get this is the patch list. And essentially, this is programmed for the synth engine of the Nord Stage 3. Just subtractive FM and wavetable synthesis. This collection recreates the most famous synth sounds of the 80s and 90s. Great. The famous Synth XL implements on some patches the drum loop function to accompany your performances. And that's pretty neat. We'll take a look at that. This one is programmed by this person here. And this Nord Sound Library is a collection of programs and samples organized in separate bundles. And that's the key here. We're going to learn how to install these too. So this is what you get. Jump. Final Countdown, I assume that's from the famous Popcorn song, some 80 strings, etc., etc. Looks like some Cyndi Lauper, some Phil Collins. What else we have? Depeche Choir, 80s keys, a Prince stab, and so forth. Now, if you want to learn what these sound like before you buy them, there's a video here included. And I think if you do a search for SynthCloud Nord within YouTube, you'll find all kinds of sound packs that you can purchase for your Nord keyboard, and you can hear them demoed ahead of time so that you know exactly what you're getting. So anyway, this is the one that my student purchased, so I figured, why not? I'll purchase it. This is the first time I'm purchasing these, but I'm pretty sure I'll be able to install it, and we'll figure this out together. So I will click Add to Cart. Okay, here's my shopping cart over here. And before I actually check out, I want to show you that if you click on sounds up here, these are all the manufacturers represented by this site. And of course, Nord is listed here. So let's take a look. Looks like we go all the way back to the Electro 3. We have the Electro 4, the Electro 5 and 6, the leads, piano 1 and 2. So there's the Stage 3, even the Stage 2, the EX and so forth. Okay, what happens after I place the order is I get a link to download the files. So I'll download those now. Okay, here I have the famous XL Nord Stage 3. This is the sound pack that I purchased. Let's take a look inside here to see how this all works. I have the Stage 3 famous synth. So this looks like a JPEG. So that's probably just an indicator of as to what I purchased. Here's the description in the form of text, along with the programmer or the designer. And so forth, and it shows you here a nice listing of that along with some of the details. Then in addition, I get some other pictures, and then the sounds themselves. So what we have here is the drum loop instructions because they work a little differently. So let's read that together real quickly. The famous Synth XL implements on some patches the drum loop function to accompany your performances to control the play and the stop of the drum loop located on the lower left split of the keyboard. Use the default hold on parameter. It's a KB hold, I think, is what they're talking about. On the slot where the drum sample is being used, and they point to the button here for the Nord Stage 3, the KB hold. So we will actually be playing with that here in a second. So that's for the drum loops. That's interesting. This is the instructions on how to install. Basically, we got to connect the Nord Stage 3 to the sound manager. Make sure you've installed piano patches in your piano partition. So these are the pianos we'll need in their exact sizes too, by the way, the Wurlitzer 2 Amp Ed XL. So this is sort of a pre-requirement because the sounds that are pre-programmed, those programs are going to need these samples. Now, these samples are all free. These particular samples for the piano are all free from the Nord website. And then it says here, copy programs and sample patches from the patches folder into your program, etc., etc. So if you follow this, it's pretty straightforward, but it might be nice to see that firsthand here in this video. So that's how to install. And then we have another quick list of the patches again. So what we have here is a list of patches along with what looks like their time in seconds according to the video. If you were to look at the demo video, I think that's what this is. All right, so let's take a look at the actual patches. Now, they are, I can already see they're well organized and nice and neat in their own folder, so it'll be easy to work with. And then it shows you here what part of the patch goes where. In other words, this for the 80s key SL program, we have the .ns3f file. So that is the actual program file. And then along with that, associated with that program is going to be the requirement of this sample library. So those two work together. And that's why they're neatly organized in these folders. But if you are brand new to working with patches or programs from a third party like this, this may all be well and good, but it may all go right over your head if you've never done this before. So if that's the case, I actually have some videos on the Nord Sound Manager, both on the Pro site as well as here on the YouTube channel. I'll put a link up in the description for that. But let's just assume that you've got the basics down of the Nord Sound Manager, and let's actually go ahead and install one of these, and let's listen to it. Okay, so here I have the Nord Sound Manager. As of this particular video recording date, which is June 1st of 2019, we're in build 7.42, so that's Nord Sound Manager, that's the version. And just recently, I updated my Nord Stage 3 OS to the latest version as well. So you want to make sure both of those are done. Now, in order for the Sound Manager to work, you have to actually connect it to your Nord Stage 3 and turn it on. So let me go do that now. Okay, I've got the Nord Stage 3 on and we are looking good. What I like to do first is I always click the Organize button. That way I can see the empty slots. If I happen to be looking at the program or any of these subcategories here, I can see what's available for me to work with. So I'm just going to keep this screen here on the right and then we'll drag these over here on the left. So let's just go ahead and install this 80s key SL. And what I would recommend is you put the sample in there first. That way it's waiting because the program is going to try to reference that sample. So let's go to the sample library because that's what we're going to install first. And I'm going to put this sample somewhere where I can find it later. I'm going to start this one in the 300s just so I know that's where I have installed the new stuff. And I'll drag this over to location 300. And you can see I already have a situation where it failed. You tried to download 3.9 megabytes of files, but the sample library partition only has 1.9 meg of free space. Please delete some files, at least 2.1, and try again. So I'm very happy that this happened because this will likely happen to you, especially if you're brand new to the Nord Stage 3 and you're not used to all this. So if that happens, we get to delete something. That's just the long and the short of it, because when you buy your Nord Stage 3, it comes fully loaded, essentially with not much room left in terms of sample library. So what I've done here is I've sorted the sample library from high to low, so I can see the biggest culprits, if you will, the larger files followed by the smaller files. And we can see here that Studio Strings Legato Vibrato is 7 megabytes. So if I click on the info button up here, it will show me if this particular sample is used by another program or not. And the good news is this particular one, not only is it large, it's not used by anything. So essentially, I won't miss it if it's gone because I haven't programmed it to a program, and neither has the factory from Nord. So let's just delete that. I will delete this particular one here. I'm just going to hit the delete key on my keyboard. And it's saying, you know, you sure you want to delete it? Yes. Now, with that in mind, let's go take a look over here. This 80s key SL, it's 4.1 meg. So I just by doing that now, I know I have plenty of room to add that sample. But while I'm at it, for good measure, let's just go see if there's any other samples that I could potentially get away with deleting. Let me just click that info button and make sure I'm sorting by size. Yes, I am. Okay. So let's take a look at this one. This one's actually being used by Studio Strings, is the name of the program. Let's take a look at the Cello Chamberlain. Okay, the Cello Chamberlain isn't used by anything. So I can delete that one too. So let's get rid of that one. And that will buy us some more room as well. Now let's do a few more, but this time I'll save you some time and save yourself some time by selecting, let's say, the top six or seven here. By clicking and then holding the shift button, it will show me a nice consolidated list of what is being used and what isn't. So I can see Duo Strings SR 3.0 is not being used, and neither is Orchestra Strings Legato. So let's see, Duo Strings and Orchestra Strings Legato, this one, neither of those. And again, I can see neither of them are being used, so I can just delete them like that. So you can get used to, it's actually pretty easy to do all this if you just take it one by one and say, okay, most of these are either being used or not, and then delete accordingly. Now that I've made enough room for that, let's just take away that info button and make sure we go down to the end where I was at my 300s here. There we go. So now I'm going to drag that sample library file over to 300. And it is moving along down here. You can see it's moving along. Now, if I go take a look at what happened here, you'll note that I don't see it down in the 300s because I don't have it sorted by location. So now I'll sort by location, and there it is. My 80s key SL sound, or some my sample, is locked and loaded, ready to go. Now, because that's done, I can move the program over to my program area, and I'll put that on bank M, because that's my next available letter. And I'll just take that program and move it over to Bank M. So what do we have here? We have the program loaded. Now let's go take a look at the info screen. And we can see here that when this program loaded, it automatically connected itself to the sample library that I had just previously loaded into the Sound Manager. So you can see here on Bank A, sample library will be the one being selected. Now on bank B, there is no sample selected. So it's likely that when we take a look at this particular program on the Nord Stage 3 directly, that bank B may not be needed for this particular program. All right, so let's do one more and then we will test just to get the hang of this. So let's take a look. Let's do one of those ones with the drum loop. And if I recall correctly, I believe that's the Phil Collins one. All right, and it's constructed similarly to the one we just did. So let's repeat what we did here. I'll go to the sample library, and hopefully I'll have enough room for this. Yeah, it's a pretty small sample. It's 1.8 megabytes. So I'll drag that to, let's say, 301. And that's now moving along nicely. And that sample is presumably the drum part for the song from Phil Collins, In the Air Tonight. And of course, we now want to bring the program over, and I'll put that into slot or bank M location 12. And that's right here. And I'll do that just like that. And just like magic, both bank A and B automatically connected itself to the sample library that it was associated with. And now, by now, you should be getting the hang of this. Let me take a quick look at any others. It looks like all of them are set up in a similar way where there's a program and a sample library. Okay, let's go hear what these sound like. Okay, this song is called The Final Countdown. It's from the band Europe. So we have here the Nord Stage 3, and I've got the program loaded. It's called The Final. That's the name of the program from the creator. And it really is interesting, and I've got to share this with you because it's worth noting. So the first thing to note is that this sound actually is derived as a split. Now, splits are nothing new for us here on this channel. We talk about splits seemingly all the time, almost on every video, it seems. But it's splitting low here on F2. So F2 is way down here between E and F down at the bottom part of the keyboard. So why are we splitting? There's only really one reason why we're splitting. It's because we need panel B to have a KB hold so that that intro part of the song, which is sampled on the C key down here, is going to be held by the KB hold. And you don't want the rest of the keyboard held because you need to play the actual song. So only that left part, that sample part on the left split, is held, and that's the only reason we're splitting the keyboard, so we can have that sound there and held. Now, here's where it gets really interesting, because in panel A, I have another sample. And this sample is derived of three different sound types. Now, wait a minute, what do I mean by that? Well, listen to this. You've got the chord part, or the pad part of the song. That's the first chord. It's a sort of like a pad. But then in my right hand, right around here, is the lead sound for that. Now that's not a pad sound. That's a lead sound. This is a pad sound. Aha! Yet there's no split happening. How in the world am I getting away with that? I've got two different sounds completely, but there's no split. There's no split point. It's literally two sounds. Well, the key is I'm using a sample. And the sample allows a creator to change and record the sound per key, if you so choose, or you can assign it to one key and have it stretch up and down and, you know, change pitch based on that relative to the key that you recorded and assigned it. But in this case, we actually have three different sounds happening with this one sample on the right side of the keyboard on panel A. You'll see panel A is only playing on the right side of the keyboard. So, all right, so we have the pad sound. Great, we have the lead sound. We have a third sound for that other part. When we play in the song, you have that pad, and then it goes sort of a fluty, breathy sound. That's a different sound. Now watch, as I play, there's my pad. There's my lead. So between E and F here is a lead. Note, there's no split. So it's sort of like magic when you think about this. And then up here, we have a split, not a split, but a built-in sort of sample split. Still a lead here. And that between B and C is my other sound. So this is how you can get away with putting many more sounds on your Nord Stage 3 than you would otherwise get as an individual split point or panel. And it really can only be done through a sample. Now, creating samples is a fairly robust and complicated process. It involves a lot of discipline, a lot of skill in terms of patience, maybe is a better word for it, because you've got to record them, save them as a WAV file, put them in the Nord sound, or put them in the Nord sample manager application, assign them to a key. It's more science than it is music. But once you get that, you have people like the person that created the sound pack creating this and making an amazing opportunity for us to completely imitate this song with just a small amount of investment. And this is just one song out of many that come with that pack. So let's just play a little bit of this and you'll get an idea of what this sounds like. Okay, the final countdown, take 15, something like that. And we'll start with the intro here on the C key. Plays the sample and let's listen. Okay, that's the very first part. Goes through that like five times. Then it at that fifth time, it goes up like this. Then the drums kick in, goes two more times, and on the second time up, does the same kind of thing. Except the flourish at the end here is a little different. Like that. And then you hold this chord, and then play up here, So that's the basics of that sound. And again, this pack is loaded with sounds from the 80s, each one having its own unique personality. Let's play with one more here. This is the beginning of True Colors from Cyndi Lauper. Again, on that C key. Hold that there. It's the beginning of that sound, or that song. Okay, and then we have In the Air Tonight, Phil Collins. Same thing, C. This one's a neat one. So these sounds are readily available on the internet. I've provided links down below in the description for you to go and grab those, check them out. And if you like it, you can really enhance your environment here if you own a Nord Stage 3 or any of the Nords pictured earlier in the video. Thanks for joining me on this video. Subscribe and like and all that good stuff, and we'll catch you on the next one.